Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidger, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. This recent event in Egypt, where they are given the death sentence to Morsi, is a good example how to subdue the sons of the greatest Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, whose statue used to be in the West when performing Hajj rites. There were three statues, and the first one represented in the East was the bastard born of the prostitutes, middle one, those who changed their tribal identity for the sake of money, like people come from India to Arabian countries, they have changed their surname, Rabbisized, so they can mix with them for the sake of money, greed. So they are number two sons of Satan, they are super bastards. And then there are two names for it, Al-Djmar Al-Kubra, are the political parties like Labour, Conservative, they have nothing to do with tribes. And then you have Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, the greatest of all, who exploit people in the name of religion, as Morsi was doing. So he is the son of the Most High Satan, and it used to be leaning against a hillock, which is the mountain of fanatics, as he has the Muslim Brotherhood. They are fanatics, same as they used to be in Jerusalem, Jews outwardly. They were sons of the Most High Satan. And that is why when Jesus was baby, Joseph was told to take the baby and mother and everyone into the Egypt while the Herod is there. Because they were sent under the safety of the sons of Abraham from the slave woman, Ishmael. They were faithful to Abraham. They remained ever, as you can notice in the parable of the prodigal son. Prodigal son is the younger one, Isaac, and his people. The elder son is the Ishmael, Egyptians, who were eating meager food, but faithful. They were surviving. And then the father is Abraham. So such things are not known to the people. The people, university professor, they are men of letters. They can only teach the letters. Gospel is preached, preaching like a sower. As I told you the meaning behind it, you may not believe it or believe it, up to you. So, here is something I have written. If you understand Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, that used to be leaning against a hillock of fanatics, then Morsi was that son of the Most High Satan. And those who are of the Muslim Brotherhood, Muslim Brotherhood are the hillocks, are the mountain of super bastard fanatics. Christ Jesus told the Jews outwardly. Remember, the Christ Jesus, to him was brought a woman who was caught in adultery. She would have produced just a bastard, a moral bastard born of the fornication. And Jesus went to the temple and told the Jews that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. But only the devil is left in the Bible, because the other thing is too harsh. And it's John 8 verse 44. So when they became Jew outwardly the tribal self, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, Judah tribe, outwardly, Jew inwardly, spiritual self. But when you replace this outwardly self, your tribal self, with spiritual self, Judah, then you are saying bye-bye to your tribal father. Then you are becoming self-made bastards. And this is the fashion of the world today. And at the time when Jesus was born, it was people of mostly chosen people, especially of Judah tribe, who had become Jew outwardly, 100% almost. Whereas the other tribal people were not so bad. Hello? Okay, my karta ring. Okay, bye. So, when Jesus went in the temple after that incident, then over there sitting in the temple, he said, your forefathers were super bastard fanatic devils because they had become Jew outwardly. And they took stones to hit him, but he dodged. So mountain of fanatic, that their forefathers were super bastard fanatic devils and they took up stones to hurt him. John 8 verse 44. Egypt, the sons of Ishmael, who was not circumcised by Abraham, for he was a son born of a slave girl. Today they are getting circumcised to be the sons of Isaac, who was circumcised, for he was the real son of Abraham, entitled to inherit the property of his father Abraham. But these Jews outwardly, But these Jews outwardly, the sons of Most High Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, started to increase the number for their business, to increase their income for Mammon. That is what Angel Stephen, who was the first administrator of the Church of God, one fold, one shepherd, headed by Christ Jesus, was exposing in the temple, and they stoned him to death. And they stoned St. James the Just to death, for he was making in God there is neither male nor female, nor Jew nor Gentile. And these clever Jews, you know, said, hey, you say these things to us. When the Passover comes, you go on the pinnacle and say the same thing to everyone. He did it. But those clever ones, you can't trust. They said, hey, look, look, he is making us equal to the Gentile. And some fanatics went and pulled him down. So that is what they were doing when Jesus' trial before Pilate, they were inciting Pilate that he proclaimed to be a king because he was proclaiming the royal kingdom of our father. So they said he is proclaiming to be king, to be inspiring against you. So you must kill him. And when Pilate put the thing, wrote that thing, the king of the Jews, then the Jews came to him, don't put this thing, we don't mean that one, don't put it. He said, what I have written is written, because Jesus had told him, you worship God in truth and in spirit. So he could not go back, Pilate. That is why in this dark age, people of conscience, they rule over the people. Those who have bad conscience, they are not allowed to rule. Otherwise, people would suffer. Now is the end of the world. Now they are allowed, and you will see how people would suffer now. So today the huge number of circumcised super bastard fanatic devils that their forefathers created shall kill them. Remember in India, you know what Indians have to do with Semitic race. People are circumcised. In Africa, people are circumcised. So when they will know that the Jews have made us the bastard, you know, then they will be all fighting against to kill them. Then who is to be blamed? Jews themselves. As the Holocaust was the blind rabbis leading the blind into the pits of sectarian riots and Holocaust. You know, if you worship God, you don't worship Mammon. You don't cheat people. If you work hard, you make Mammon to live upon, as Christ Paul was doing, tent making. He wasn't a parasite on the church. Today, these dog collar people, they are parasite. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. At the end of the month, they want salary taken from the church purse donations. Is that their conscience? So they are antichrist. So if you want to worship God, seek Christ Jesus in the royal vineyard of our Father, where he has been planted by our Father. It has a narrow gate, and you have to seek yourself. Nobody can tell you where the narrow gate is. So once you start seeking, our Father will let you know the way to the narrow gate. And then there is a kiln of his word, fire. Jesus said, I have brought fire. And you have to pass through that one. That means you have to preach gospel. Gospel hurts people because they have been given the sugar-coated tablets of falsehood. Politicians, they hate gospel. So are these dog-collar people because they worship Mammon. The other day, I was 17th May, there was a BBC One debate, big question, and I was there in the afternoon. And there was a reverend who was a vicar, and he had no dog collar because he had retired from the job of vicar. Only he could put the dog collar when he was a vicar. And when the presenter addressed him, Vicar David Patterson, he said, no, don't call me a vicar. I'm not a vicar. I have retired from that job. I'm no more a vicar. Don't call me vicar, please. He was surprised, taken aback. I was laughing. You know, this man, all the whole life, he worked like a policeman with uniform. And when he reached the retiring age, he retired. He retired from the job of the vicar also. So he was all the time working for money. The topic was, who is God? Or what is God? I was telling him, what the hell he knows about God when he was working all the life for Mammon. So this is the intelligence of the people in Oxford, where they even don't know, university professors have no idea the difference between teaching and preaching. So I call them super donkeys carrying holy books, and they get annoyed. So you should be open-minded and strict, and don't twist gospel. You have to keep the straight path. If you go this way and that way to please the people, you are lost. Our Father won't be happy with you. It's up to you. Our Father God blesses you.